we now discuss the solution of a problem from the section analysis, and the problem is on the cardinality of a given set. This problem has appeared in CSIR National Eligibility Test held on 30th November 2020, and it is from the section C. The problem is, consider the set capital S is equal to the set consisting of exponential in brackets 2 pi I theta bracket close, where theta is a rational number. S is the set consisting of e power 2 pi I theta, where theta is a rational number. For each z belongs to S, the set consisting of z power n factorial, n is a positive integer, is, the four options are given to us. Option 1, countable. Option 2, countably infinite. Option 3, uncountable. Option 4, finite. No, you are given a set S, and for each z belongs to S, you have to consider for each z belongs to S, this set, the set consisting of z to the power of n factorial, n is a positive integer, and you have to find out the cardinality of this set for each z belongs to S. So you take an arbitrary element z belongs to S, and then consider this set and discuss its cardinality. Before entering into the discussion of the problem, let us now recall, you know, the definitions of countably infinite, countable and uncountable. A set is countably infinite if it is equivalent to n, the set of natural numbers. Equivalent means if it is in 1-to-1 correspondence with n, that is, if there exists a function from the set to n which is bijective, then it is said to be equivalent, then the set is said to be countably infinite. A set is said to be countable set if it is either finite or countably infinite. A set is said to be uncountable if it is not countable. I am sure you are familiar with these definitions. Let us enter into the discussion of the solution of this problem. Solution: we have the given set S is equal to e power 2 pi I theta, where theta belongs to the set of rational numbers. Let z be any element of S, then how this z will be? Z is equal to e to the power of 2 I pi theta for some theta belongs to Q, the set of rational numbers. Let theta, because theta is a rational number, let theta is equal to P by Q, where P belongs to Z and Q belongs to Z plus, that is the set of positive integers. So if it is a negative rational number, then P will be a negative integer and Q will be positive. So you always keep Q to be a positive integer. Let T, for this Z, we have to consider the set T is equal to the set consisting of Z power n factorial, where n belongs to the set of natural numbers. So for each Z, we are considering this set as it is required, and we are calling it as T. Now the question is, what is the cardinality of this T? That is it finite? Is it countably infinite or uncountable, or is it countable? So these are the four things you have to discuss. Now T is equal to, for that Z, given Z, Z power n factorial, n belongs to n. Z is any arbitrarily chosen element of S. And that is equal to the set consisting of Z is e to the power of 2i pi theta to the power of n factorial, n belongs to n. This we have written e to the power of 2 pi I power n factorial whole to the power of theta, n belongs to n. And it is brought forward here, and e to the power of 2 pi I is 1. That is equal to the set consisting of 1 to the power of p by q, p belongs to z, and q is a positive integer. And that will be equal to the set consisting of 1 power 1 by q, q belongs to the set of natural numbers. That means the T consists of the qth powers of the qth roots of 1. Qth roots of. So T is the set of qth roots of unity, and how many qth roots of unity will be there? There will be qth roots of unity, and therefore the cardinality of T is equal to Q. That means the cardinality of T is finite. When it is finite, it is also countable. Therefore T is finite and hence countable. Let's look at our options. In our options, option 4 is finite and option 1 is countable. Since it is finite, it is also countable. Therefore, the options 1 and 4 are true. Since it is finite, it is not countably infinite and it is not uncountable. Therefore, the options 2 and 3 are not true, and hence our answer is that the set for each Z, the set consisting of Z power n factorial, n is a positive integer, is finite and countable. This is for each Z, for each Z. So our answer is options 1 and 4, they are true. So that is the discussion of the solution of a problem from the section analysis, and the problem is on the cardinality of a given set. I hope that you have understood the solution of this problem, and I wish you all the best. Thank you.